Hi guys, today I'm making video about Intel stock, which is stock I own, and yesterday there was earnings, so I think it's a good time to look at this stock. And it is interesting that it is trading around 11 PE ratio, like other stocks or even S&P 500 index is trading around 30 or 40 PE ratio. So what's more I like about this company, even from financial results, we see that this company rewards shareholders. They paid dividends and doing share repurchase program, and almost 20 billion returned to shareholders. That I really like. So I bought Intel stock below 50, and now it's really going upside because there was announcement of new CEO, and yesterday was results leaked a bit earlier, so that's why it was going up so much. And I would say that last year earnings, it was really nice, and for the price I paid for the stock. So now let's look at the outlook of next first quarter. And as we can see, we are expecting the revenue, margin, and earnings will go down a bit. I could say we are conservative. And if we look, yes, we are expecting it will be lower. So now let's look at the 10-year the financial results from the data from the Morningstar. As we can see, the revenue was growing, operating income too, dividends growing, doubled over 10 years, and I am interested in free cash flow because we are rewarding shareholders by returning it to them by buying shares or paying dividends. So if we see, it's 20 billion, and I entered Intel stock information in the spreadsheet where I talk about it in last video where I found it on the internet. So this is data from Morningstar. I left empty for growth rate and for discount rate, and added new sheet of compound annual growth rate. That means this is formula for counting annual growth. And if we take 10 billion, and 10 years it was 20 billion, now we'll count annual growth rate. So beginning was 10 billion, and now 20 billion. And it take it 10 years, we can see that annual compound growth rate would be 7%. So with a lower guidance on the first quarter this year, I could say it's expecting 5% growth rate for the next 5 years, and for the next one 5.2, because with inflation, is a tech stock, I think it's doable for them. And then I discount rate, I enter number which I want to earn. So with 15% discount rate, intrinsic value would be $46, and I would say it's around same price I paid for Intel stock. If we look at the charts, we see the trend is up. I will draw a few lines even from here. Trend is up, and I bought it below 50, intrinsic value around 46, and it is the time. Sorry, phone call. And so intrinsic value 46, and look at this line, it sums up with the price, and actually it's where I bought. So my next target for the buy price would be below 40. So from the technical perspective, it would be, I would really like to buy it around $38, and we will see what will happen. So we find out intrinsic value, current share price, and if we look at PE ratio by the other companies or even index, we see that evaluation, if it would be 30, share price by earnings in 3 years would be 180, almost $90. Of course, it's a bit too exuberant because Intel is now delaying a product which is main revenue. It's 7 nanometers chips. We are delaying it 2 years from now to 2023 year. So I don't know in which presentation we saw, yes, in this client computing group, I think this is where we selling chips, and with delay we don't have good advantage before other competitors. That's one of the reason I think we are so low evaluated by the price earnings ratio. But I count this, I couldn't say count, I think of it like a cyclical stock, and we have hard times making new chips. That's, well, it's good opportunity, let's say, to accumulate the stock, because when the 23 year comes and we have new chips, we have complete advantage, and the margins will be higher for sure. Because what is more interesting, that Intel chips on nanometers has more speed and less power consumption than other nanometers chips. Like Intel's 10 nanometer chips is equal other competitors 7 nanometer chips. So if we make in few years a 7 nanometer chips, I think we will back on track with good margins and good return to shareholders. For now, we are expecting lower growth, decrease in revenue, but I think it's temporary. So when we make new chips, I think we can everyone will evaluate it a bit better, maybe 20, 25 P/E ratio, and that would mean, don't know, maybe $6 per earnings multiple by 25, we could see 150 of $150 per share with good evaluation. With few years coming till the new chips, I think we could see our opportunity to buy Intel share below 40 if free cash flow will decrease too. So I will watch Fontel stock and hope we'll see these buy levels. So that's it on this video. If you like it, please like, click subscribe. If you have any questions, comment, and see you in the next one.